Hey everyone, welcome back to another video of Law Wisdom. Today's topic is sexual harassment at workplace. So in this video, we are going to talk about firstly, what is sexual harassment? Second, Indian Constitution on sexual harassment. Third, Indian Penal Code on sexual harassment. Fourth, Sexual Harassment at Workplace Prohibition Act 2013. The next point is prevention of sexual harassment. Then what is internal complaint committee? And lastly, we are going to see what is employer's responsibility towards it. Today's world is accustomed to the term sexual harassment. Accustomed means familiar. Sexual harassment can be identified as a behavior. It can, in general terms, be defined as unwelcome behavior of sexual nature. Sexual harassment at workplace is a universal problem in the world. It is seen to be happening more with the woman gender. Hence, Sexual Harassment at Workplace Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Act 2013 was enacted to protect women from sexual harassment. Then, what is sexual harassment? In 1997, in the landmark judgment of Vishakha and other versus State of Rajasthan, the Supreme Court of India identified, or we can say defined, sexual harassment at workplace. So the following things include sexual harassment. First, actual or attempted rape or sexual assault. Second, unwanted, deliberate touching, leaning over, and cornering or pinching. Thirdly, unwanted sexual teasing, jokes, remarks or questions. Fourth, kissing sounds or hauling and smacking lips. Fifth, touching an employee's clothes, hair or body. Sixth, touching or rubbing oneself sexually around another person. And the last, whistling at someone is also amounted to sexual harassment. Then what is Indian Constitution says on sexual harassment? Sexual harassment clearly violates the fundamental rights of women to the equality under Article 14. Article 15, that is prohibition of discrimination on a ground of sex. Article 21, that is right to life and personal liberty. And Article 19, Clause G, right to practice any profession. Indian Penal Code on sexual harassment. In 2013, substantial changes were made in IPC regarding sexual harassment. The Criminal Law Amendment Act 2013 included Section 354A of IPC that defines sexual harassment, that is, unwelcome physical contact and advances, including unwanted and explicit sexual overture, a demand or a request for sexual favors, showing someone sexual images without their consent, and making unwanted sexual remarks. Such activities are punishable up to 3 years in a prison and with a fine. Section 354B says that forcing a woman to undress is also punishable 3 to 7 years imprisonment. The next point is Sexual Harassment at Workplace Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Act 2013. This act was finally enacted in the year of 2013 for the prevention of sexual harassment against the woman at workplace. In India, the main object of the act is protection of a woman, prevention and redressal of a sexual harassment complaints. According to Section 2N of this act, sexual harassment includes any one or more of the following unwelcome acts or a behavior, whether directly or by implication, namely physical contact and advances. Second, a demand or a request for sexual favors. Third, making sexually colored remarks. Fourth, showing pornography. Fifth, any other unwelcome physical, verbal or non-verbal conduct of sexual nature. Prevention of sexual harassment. Section 3 of this act makes provision for prevention of sexual harassment. It provides that no woman shall be subjected to the sexual harassment at any workplace. The harassment may include implied or explicit promise of preferential treatment in her employment. Preferential means special treatment or better treatment. Second, implied or explicit threat of detrimental treatment in her employment. Detrimental means dangerous or bad, or we can say evil treatment. Third, implied or explicit threat about her present or a future employment status, like nikal dene ki dhamki, interference with her work, or creating an intimidating or offensive or a hostile work environment for her. Means bar bar uske kaam mein dakhal dena ya fir uska work environment bitter bana dena. And the last, humiliating treatment likely to affect her health or a safety. Next point is Constitution of Internal Complaint Committee. Section 4 states that every employer of a workplace shall by an order in a writing constitute a committee to be known as Internal Complaint Committee at every administrative unit or office. The Internal Complaint Committee consists of the following members to be nominated by the employer, namely a presiding officer who shall be a woman employed at a senior level at a workplace from amongst the employees. Next, not less than two members from amongst the employees having the experience in social work or having legal knowledge. Then next, one person from amongst non-governmental organization or association or any person familiar with the issues relating to sexual harassment. Provided that at least half of the total members so nominated shall be women, and the presiding officer and every member of the committee shall hold the office not less than 3 years. What is employer's responsibility towards it? According to Section 19, every employer should provide safe working environment for women. Employer should display at workplace consequences of sexual harassment. Employer should organize workshop and awareness programs at regular intervals. Employer should provide necessary facilities to the Internal Complaint Committee. He should make available all such information to the Internal Complaint Committee. He should provide assistance to woman if she chooses to file a complaint in relation to this. This act makes it mandatory for every employer to constitute Internal Complaint Committee to provide resolution to employees. It is the duty of the employer to treat sexual harassment as a misconduct, and it is the duty of the employer to ensure Internal Complaint Committee prepares and submits annual report. So that's all for the today's video, guys. Hope you like this video, and don't forget to like, share, subscribe and comment. Thanks for watching.